गुड मॉर्निंग चिल्ड्रन, क्लास 10 ट्रिग्नोमेट्री। टुडे वी विल डिस्कस एक्सरसाइज 8.4। लेट अस डिस्कस फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन। राइट ऑल द ट्रिग्नोमेट्रिक रेशियोज ऑफ एंगल ए इन टर्म्स ऑफ सीकेंट ए। मीन्स वी हैव टू राइट ऑल ट्रिग्नोमेट्रिक रेशियोज इन टर्म्स ऑफ सीकेंट। फर्स्ट आइडेंटिटी वी हैव टेकन हियर, यू कैन सी साइन स्क्वायर ए प्लस कॉस स्क्वायर ए इक्वल टू 1 and cos square is shifted on the other side, that is 1 minus cos square. Cos square can be written as 1 upon secant square because secant and cos are reciprocal of each other. Then take LCM. After taking LCM, we are getting secant square a minus 1 upon secant square a. But we have to find out sine a. That's why we have to take square root on both the sides. After taking square root, we are getting sine a in terms of secant. In the denominator, secant square a can be taken with square root, will become secant a only. Means square root is left only in the numerator, that is secant square a minus 1 root upon secant. Now sine a in terms of secant. The next is cos a. Cos and secant already they are reciprocal of each other, that's why directly they can be written as cos a equal to 1 upon secant a. Next, 1 plus tan square a equal to secant square a is identity. Now 1 is shifted on the other side and take square root on both the sides. So means tan a again in terms of secant. There are three trigonometric ratios, sine a in terms of secant a, cos a in terms of secant a, and tan a in terms of secant. The next is cosec a. Cosec a can be written as 1 upon sine a. Sine a already we found here. Take reciprocal of it, we will get cosec. By taking reciprocal, we are getting cosec in terms of secant. Next, last is left, cot a. Cot a can be written as 1 upon tan a. And tan a we have here, it is square root of secant square a minus 1. By taking reciprocal of it, we will get cot a. So similarly, we are getting here cot a. This is 1 upon tan a, and tan a is square root of secant square a minus 1. So in this way, we are getting all trigonometric ratios in terms of secant. Now next question is number 2. Sin square 63 plus sin square 27 degree upon cos square 17 degree plus cos square 73 degree. We have to find out value of this evaluated. These two rules we know, sin theta is cos 90 minus theta and cos theta is sin 90 minus theta. So we are applying here, it is sin 27 degree cos 90 minus 27 degree. Sin theta cos 90 minus theta. Theta is 27 degree. Square as it is. And similarly, cos theta is sin 90 minus theta. Theta is 73 degree. Therefore, we are getting cos square 90 minus 27. 90 minus 27 will become 63 and 90 minus 73 will become 70. So here we are getting sin square 63 plus cos square 63 and here cos square 17 plus sin square 17. We know that sin square theta plus cos square theta equal to 1. So in the numerator we are applying sin square theta plus cos square theta equal to 1. Theta means angle both are same. That's why we can write 1 here. And similarly, sin square theta plus cos square theta again 1. And 1 upon 1 is 1. Means value of this, evaluation of this is 1. Similarly, we can discuss next question, which is sin 25 degree, cos 65 degree plus cos 25 degree, sin 65 degree. Here again, we are applying cos theta is sin 90 minus theta and sin theta is cos 90 minus theta. We know that 90 minus 65 is 25. That's why we are writing here 25 degree. And 90 minus 65 is again 25. All angles are in 25. Here sin 25 means sin square 25 degree. And cos 25 is cos square 25 degree. And again we are applying this identity, which is sin square theta plus cos square theta. Sin square 25 degree plus cos square 25 degree equal to 1. So in this way we are solving, we are finding the values of these expressions. Now how to solve next question? Let me discuss. You can see here, just a minute. 9 secants ke liye minus 9 tens ke liye. You can see here 9 we can take common. Secants ke liye minus tens ke liye is left. And again second identity is secants ke liye minus tens ke liye is 1. That's why we are writing 1 and 9 into 1 is 9. So we are getting the value of this expression. Now next question is 1 plus tan theta plus secant theta into 1 plus cot theta minus cosec theta. And we have to again evaluate it. How to evaluate it? We are just changing all the trigonometric functions in terms of sine theta and cos theta. Now what we know, let us discuss here. It is tan theta, which is sine theta upon cos theta. Secant theta is 1 upon cos theta. Cot theta is cos theta upon sine theta. And cosec theta is 1 upon sine theta. Let's take LCM of all. After taking LCM, we are getting cos theta. Cos theta into 1 is cos theta. It is sine theta and plus 1 as it is. Similarly, we took LCM here, sine theta. Sine theta into 1 is sine theta plus cos theta minus 1. Here you can see here, cos theta plus sine theta, I took in a bracket. And this one plus 1 as it is. And similarly, I am writing it is cos theta plus sine theta. In case of plus sign, किसी को भी हम पहले किसी को भी हम बाद में लिख सकते हैं. So we are getting here cos theta plus sin theta minus 1. Denominator cos theta sin theta as it is. Now you can see here, this term cos theta plus sin theta and this term is also cos theta plus sin theta both are same. Here it is plus 1, here it is minus 1. Means this is a plus b into a minus b. This formula we can apply here. A is cos theta plus sin theta and b is 1. So we can apply here for a plus b into a minus b. This is a square minus b square. You can see here a square minus b square is a square minus b square. And denominator is as it is. Now after it, a plus b whole square can be applied. A square plus b square plus 2ab minus 1 as it is. And we know sin square theta plus cos square theta is first identity, which is 1. And therefore we are getting 1 here. And therefore 1 is cancelled with minus 1. And what is left? 2 cos theta sin theta upon cos theta sin theta. Again, they are cancel all each other. And what is left? 2. The value of this expression is 2. So in this way, we are solving these kind of questions. Now you can see the next one. Secant a plus tan a into 1 minus sin a. How to simplify this? Again, we are changing in terms of sin and cos. After changing sin and cos, we are getting here 1 upon cos A plus sin A upon cos A. By taking LCM, we can write 1 plus sin A upon cos A. 1 plus sin A into 1 minus sin A we are getting, and you can see here, this is 1 plus sin A into 1 minus sin A. Denominator cos A as it is. Again, we are applying here A plus B into A minus B, that is A square minus B square. That is 1 square minus sin square A we are getting. And 1 square is 1. 1 minus sin square is cos square A is first identity. Cos cos cancel. By simplifying, we are getting cos A. Now next and the last question, 1 plus A upon 1 plus cot square A. We know that 1 plus tan square A is secant square A and 1 plus cot square A is cosec square A. These are all identities. We are changing in terms of sine and cos. And after changing sine and cos, secant square A can be written as 1 upon cos square A. Cosec square A can be written as 1 upon sine square A. Sine square A will be in the numerator. Therefore, sin square upon cos square will become tan square. This is simplification of these kind of questions. So in this way, we are using trigonometric identities. I think it is clear to everyone. And we will discuss more questions based on